Hello friends, welcome to pharmatopoeia.com. We'll be able to see reactions and rearrangement. Okay? Reactions and rearrangement. This is the most important topic as per our syllabus. Reactions and rearrangement. First, I would like to reintroduce with the some molecules like aldehyde and ketones. First we see the rearrangement which are related to aldehyde and ketones. Okay, so first when we study chemistry, first we know the physical and chemical nature of the molecule. So we first study about their chemical nature and then we proceed for their rearrangement. Okay, so first is aldehyde and ketones general formula. So the hybridization is sp2. So the bond angle is 120 degrees Celsius. 120 degree is okay, and then geometry is tetra. Okay, this is their hybridization pattern. So it's a, it has a planar geometry and 120 degrees Celsius. So and second is this oxygen is present. So this molecule has polarity. Okay, in case of we talk about solubility, it is soluble in water, but mainly lower aldehydes and ketones are soluble in water because they can involve in hydrogen bonding. Next, their melting and boiling points. Their melting and boiling points are quite low than acids and alcohol. Why? They are not able to form hydrogen bonding between the molecules. So their melting and boiling points are lower than acids and alcohols. Okay. Next, in case of reactivity, what type of reactions may be given by aldehyde and ketones? First, where do you see this molecule? In this molecule, this oxygen is the main part. This oxygen is electronegative. So this is the direction of electronegativity. This electronegativity is due to inductive effect. That inductive effect is minus inductive effect. So due to that minus inductive effect, it creates O minus. Okay. So this is positive charge. This electrons, these pi electrons are pulled by on oxygen, so it forms minus charge on oxygen and it forms plus charge. So aldehyde and ketones mainly gives nucleophilic addition reaction. Why? Because this nucleophile minus charge will attack on this positive part, then we call it as a carbocation. Okay, so it will easily attack. Okay, and in this there is no elimination because we know that for there is no elimination, not there is no substitution, because for substitution reaction we have a good leaving group. But in case of aldehyde and ketone, hydrogen is present or CH3 group is present, and we know that the alkanes are bad leaving groups. So there is no substitution reaction, there is addition reaction. So this nucleophile and this, and mainly aldehyde and ketone reactions are taking place in acidic condition. So acidic condition, why? I will tell you the reason for that. See, this is OH, R, R. Okay, and this nucleophile is added. Okay, we will see one reaction for that. Now, you will understand better. One reaction is CH3, C double bond O H. When we add hydrogen cyanide in this reaction, okay, hydrogen cyanide, you know, this is weak acid. We know we have to run this reaction in acidic medium. Why? We know that in acidic medium, this lone pair of electrons will attract the positive ions from the solution. So it forms mainly CH3, C double bond O H plus. Why? This lone pair gets dominated. Then to neutralize this positive charge, this pi electrons goes to oxygen and it forms carbonyl. Carbocation. So it forms mainly CH3, C dash O H, positive charge, hydrogen. Okay. Now carbocation is generated. So it is electrophilic center. We know that reaction has only two parts. That one is nucleophile and is second is electrophile. So nucleophile attacks on nucleophile attacks on electrophile. So what is the nucleophile in this reaction? That is hydrogen cyanide. So CN minus. Okay. In minus will attack on this gains product OH hydrogen is a okay. There is no scope for elimination in substitution reaction or elimination because there is no substitution. This is hydrogen change. How can we substitute this? These are very poorly removed. So now we understand the this question is comes in GPAT 2013. That what type of reaction is being given by allied and neutral? That is nucleophilic. Nucleophilic addition reaction. How it is? Now we understand that this is a nucleophile. Okay, and this is positive, so nucleophile will add in this so nucleophilic, and this is adding this allylic compound to nucleophilic addition reaction. There is no elimination. Okay, same in this case of we see the molecule ligand, but in case of acids and esters, they use different type of mechanism because they have a good ligands. Like in case of acids. This is a general formula for acids. Okay. Acid reaction is also running in acidic medium. So, when we use some catalyst like catalyst reagent, we take any reagent, like sodium oxide or anything that you take any nucleophile, generally we take general example. Nucleophile, when it forms, but in this case of acids, this OH group is also bad living group, so we have to convert it into good living group. So many we use PCl3, PCl5 and SOCl2. So it will be converted into R-COCl. Okay. So we know that chlorine is a better living group than OH. So then we substitute different like G add ammonium. Okay. We add ammonia, then it forms R-OH2. That is the final form. So from this reaction, we come to know that acids are generally given the substitution reaction. What type of substitution? That thing, what type of substitution it is? Substitution reaction. Substitution reaction is mainly given by acids, and it is nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now we have to go. Now I will explain some reactions which are related to the aldehyde and ketone molecules and some reactions also. That is, first reaction is aldol condensation. Aldol condensation. Everyone knows about aldol condensation, it's a very famous reaction. Okay. In aldol condensation, first we see the general chemistry of aldehyde and ketone. First, this is CH3 aldol. We call it as the acetaldehyde, and in this is the alpha carbon. Okay, so this oxygen has two advantages. First advantage is that it generates electrophilic center due to the electronegativity, so it gives nucleophilic addition reaction. Second advantage is that due to this oxygen atom, it withdraws electron from CH3 group, so it will create this. Three hydrogens are become acidic. So all are acidic. So they can be removed easily. So it will also give the it will generate carbonyl. Okay. So nucleophilic addition reaction is all type of general reactions that comes in nucleophilic addition reaction. And this carbonyl is generated, so that is aldol condensation. This type of reactions is also given by acid and esters also that we will see in nature. First here we see aldol condensation. Aldol condensation has one most important thing that the aldehyde or ketone has. First, this reaction is given by both molecules, aldehyde and ketone. But in case of ketone, this reaction is not more favorable, it is very poor. In case of aldehydes, ketones, this reaction is given by aldehyde and ketones. Second point is alpha hydrogen must be present. Why? We know that if alpha hydrogen is not present, carbonyl is not generated. So how can the LP process for reaction? Okay. Right, alpha hydrogen. Third requirement is that the reaction is in alkaline or mild acidic condition. Okay. These are all sufficient points for Aldol condition. Now we will see the reaction, actual reaction. Now, this first is that we directly go to mechanism. First, CH3, C double bond O dash H. We call it as acetaldehyde. And this is the alpha carbon, so these all are alpha hydrogen. So, this is CH2, this is hydrogen. This is acidic hydrogen in presence of alkali and NaOH. NaOH has OH minus ion, so this OH minus will abstract this proton. Two things we have to remember, that when proton is removed, means hydrogen has two parts. When we talk about hydrogen, when it will go without hydrogen, we call it as a proton. When it goes with electron, we call it as a hydride ion. So, we have to keep this thing in your mind, because when hydrogen is acidic, there is proton, then it will means goes with electron when it is hydride ion. Okay, in this case, it is proton. So, it leaves with electron. So, if this is removed, then it forms carbonyl ion. CH2, C double bond, O, that, S, then this is inhibited. So, this carbonyl is generated. So, we have to use this carbonyl in second part. Okay. Second part is that CH2, I will change this structure, that CH2 minus, this is a hydrogen. We have to take second molecule of acetaldehyde in this, that is CH3, hydrogen, C2O. Now we know that this is carbonyl, so it is a group nucleophile, it will attack on this aldehyde. What is the reaction center? First, in each reaction we know the where the nucleophile will attack. In these three, this is the more electrophilic, so it will attack on this. So the reaction goes that we will write it as a C4O as CH2. Next, this COH. COH is CH and this CH3. Okay? Now, see that this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon. Okay? So, what final product is? Beta. So, beta hydroxy aldehyde. So, final product is beta hydroxy acetaldehyde. Or simply beta hydroxy acetaldehyde. No? It's a 1, 2, 3, 4. So, beta aldehyde. Beta aldehyde. Okay? You can get this. Beta aldehyde. So, final is that when we the compounds, the aldehyde and ketones which contains alpha hydrogen, when in presence of alkali, it forms mainly carbonyl ions, and this carbonyl is added into second molecule of acetaldehyde and it forms alpha hydroxy aldehydes of ketones. Okay? So this is all about aldol condensation. But main thing is that this is the final product. Last thing, this of CH3, C double. It will means this final product is then we remove hydride ion, means minus H2O from that, and it forms a protonyl aldehyde. Okay. But main thing is that cross aldol condensation is also there. In cross aldol, we mainly use two different aldehydes. Two different ketones, or we use also one aromatic and one is aliphatic. So products are different reactions which are generated in this reaction which are called aldol condensation. This is also important. In aldol condensation, when subsequent reactions happen, the resins are formed. So in continuous reaction, many resins are formed. So in preparation of many aldol condensation will take place. So this is all about aldol condensation. Right? Next reaction is candidate that we will see in next lecture.